Light. Welcome to the Walnut Desk Podcast. I'm Will.
And I'm Ryan.
Today we're going to talk about fast food, but first we have some announcements.
That's right. We're switching our day of release. We're going to Mondays.
Mondays. Start your week off right. Don't end it with us. Start it with us.
Start it with us. Start it with our bullshit. We're switching to Mondays because it's easier for us and I don't know.
Why else? We have jobs.
We have other jobs we have to do.
I am a teacher and editing the podcast
during the week
and making the podcast during the week, it doesn't work for Ryan. It doesn't work for me starting Monday. So we're switching.
Mondays. So be there. It's going to be in your feeds every Monday morning now instead of Friday around like 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. It'll be there
now
Sunday
night. Now you can have that Game of Thrones level tension where you have to wait through your whole shitty working week to hear our sweet, sweet voices once more.
Or use our sweet, sweet voices to make your whole shitty work week a little better.
Go through the archives. Listen to Teeth again. Remember Teeth? That was a good one.
Yeah. It's like so many people who have been listening since the first episode have told me that Teeth is their favorite still.
So we're never going to match that again, so just go back and
listen to it again.
I know we say no, don't go back, but go back and listen to Teeth.
Go back.
If you miss us. We are going on a podcast tour.
Yeah.
Woohoo.
So we're still looking for booking for other podcasts. We have one.
So if you're not the Desert Island Discourse, let us know if you want us on your podcast.
I mean, we are going to get on other podcasts. It's going to happen.
Yeah.
So it might as well be yours. Or if you have a suggestion, honestly, for a podcast you think that we should be on, send it our way. Because we should
be on other podcasts. We're trying to spread the love all over the place.
And just, like, throw in, get more interesting voices, because, like, the idea is that if we get to know other people and have them on, it just makes it better for everyone's listeners. It should be a community thing.
Yes, definitely. Without further ado, we are going to start talking about fast food. But normally we read a definition for you off of Google, but today we're not.
No.
We're going to just try to suss out what is fast food, Ryan?
The definition is part of the discussion.
Yeah.
What is fast food, Will?
I think it's food that you get quickly.
Any food that you get quickly?
Yes.
Any food?
No. Food that you get from a food provider that is already ready to eat.
Okay.
So if I were to buy a frozen pizza, I would not consider that fast food, even though I may be able to cook it very quickly. It's not fast food because I didn't go to a place that served me ready to eat food.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Oh, so they give you a meal that you can just kind of like take with you, like take out food.
Or eat there. Or have delivered quickly.
Okay. So how fast is fast though? Because what separates that experience you just described from the experience of going to a restaurant where they just made your food really quick?
That's true. I mean, I think the go-to, you think of like the McDonald's experience, right?
Yeah.
Where you could drive through
the
place and have your food handed to you at, like, in less time than it took you to pay. Like, somehow they've, like, made it already, and they're just scooping it and giving it to you.
So, like, the drive up or drive through aspect.
I mean, I think that's one tier.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, well, I think that's true. I think that's, like, the standard fast food is your Burger King, your McDonald's, your Taco Bell, where you just drive through and you leave with your food.
Is there a reason you led with Burger King and not McDonald's, Ryan?
No, not really.
I was wondering if it was alphabetism, favoritism, or some other ism.
No isms. Just think of it ism. Order in which I came up with it ism.
Kingism.
Kingism. But yeah, so that's like definitely, you're right, there's a tier. But then there's walk-in fast food.
Okay.
Or like drive-up fast food, like Sonic. Right? You drive up and then they bring it to you, to your car.
But you're not allowed to drive through. You have to eat it in your car.
Right. Exactly. You have to eat it in your car. Which is usually what I do when I get fast food anyway.
Have you been to Sonic?
Never.
Okay.
Have you?
No. And there's one, like, right there.
Oh, shit. Really?
Like a mile away.
Yeah.
And we should probably go there after this podcast.
Let's go.
And review it.
Yeah. We should probably check it out.
Do like a video.
Definitely. So watch out for that. But, like, there's also walk-in fast food. Like, I would consider Subway fast food.
Yes.
Definitely.
Oh, yes. But there's never... Have you seen a Subway with a drive-thru?
No.
Do they exist?
I haven't. I don't know.
I don't think they exist.
Would you consider the food at Starbucks fast food? Because yes.
Yeah.
And, or like any coffee shops.
But they heat do up like frozen they do shit. This weird hipster fast food.
Yeah, like
where
what?
It's like they like make you your typical McDonald's or Dunkin' Donuts breakfast. Yeah. But they put it on sourdough, and therefore it's worth $5.99 now.
Yeah, it's bullshit.
I don't get. I can't do Starbucks food.
No.
Like it's too much.
Or sheets.
It's kind of gross. Like, I would rather, if I'm going to get something that's going to get heated up in one of those toaster microwave hybrids,
yep.
I would rather go to McDonald's and pay half price for the same quality thing. Like, I don't want to trick myself into thinking I'm eating highbrow fast food at Starbucks.
Totally. Yeah, no, I agree.
I like McDonald's coffee better, too.
Or Dunkin' Donuts.
I mean, I don't really like it better, but the price difference, like, makes me evaluate it as being better.
Yeah, no, I understand that. Yeah, the price to benefit, price to taste ratio.
And I feel like that's how I evaluate most things in my life.
Okay,
like
so maybe
price to benefit ratio.
Right, and maybe one of the defining characteristics of fast food is the price to taste ratio. Like the taste can't get too high.
I think we're onto it. I think we're like circling around the hunt right now for our definition of fast food. So something that is served to you quickly, whether it's walk in, walk out, drive through.
But I think there's a third tier.
What's the third tier?
Delivery.
Ooh.
Because I would consider Domino's to be fast food.
Yeah.
Would you?
Well, no, because it takes forever.
It takes like 40 minutes.
Like you order, right. Yeah. But that's not fast.
That's driving time.
Right.
Yeah.
And my thing is like, Domino's is a chain, sure.
It's a chain.
But the food's not fast, it's just bad.
It's just bad. Well, it's convenient.
But it's still bad. Like, like
if you order it before you want it, then it comes when you want it.
That's true.
And if we're thinking about the taste-to-cost ratio, it might be in the sweet spot of fast food.
Don't they do, like, $5 pizzas?
Yeah.
And somehow they can afford to pay a dude to drive those around town?
I know. How do they do that? I don't know.
Tip money? Yeah. It's, like, legal loophole that needs to be closed that, like, people can
pay.
Oh,
I'm cool with it.
That you can, like, pay your... No, but, like, I just think... Let me go on a little rant
about
how non-European we are here in this country. We shouldn't be tipping people. We should be paying our service staff enough money to live and not rely on random chance.
We should be paying everyone enough money to live.
Right.
Our living wages in the United States, especially we live in the Bay Area, wage to living cost ratio is just fucking insane here.
Right. We live in the Bay Area where people hang their bikes from the handholds on BART. We should be making more money.
Yeah, I agree.
We're smarter than that. We're cooler than that.
But our economy doesn't support paying people what they need to live.
No, and it's kind of fucked up.
It is fucked up. And it drives us to fast food.
To Domino's. Because
we can't afford other shit.
To Domino's, where they drive us the fast food. And it's not that good.
Did you know?
So I don't know if I can consider Domino's fast food. I think it's bad slow food.
It's bad slow food. Okay. I just I'll say so like
cuz if you went to the store, it still would take 15 minutes for them to make you a pizza.
But I would eat Domino's in the same situations in which I would eat any other fast food.
That's true. Have you been to Little Caesars?
Never.
Besides the high fructose corn syrup and their tomato sauce, which you can like clearly taste.
Gross.
$5 for a large pizza is a pretty good deal. And if you cover it in hot sauce, it kind of tastes like real food.
That might be the trick, though, to fast food. Like, a lot of fast food, if you cover it in hot sauce, then it's better.
Touché.
Especially, breakfast fast food. Like, breakfast sandwiches.
What's your favorite?
I don't really know what my favorite fast food breakfast is. It used to be Burger King, because they had those French toast sticks. And I was a big fan of the dippable French toast sticks.
So they gave you like a sweet and sour sauce-sized packet of like syrup?
Yeah.
And you would dip your French toast sticks into
it? Yeah, like in the syrup and then eat them. That's as a child.
French toast sticks are gross.
I know.
Like in general, even the ones that like may be made by a human.
But that was
human,
my favorite until I was probably like 17. You know, it was like a big chunk of my life.
So that's your number one breakfast fast food. So you said till you were 17. So what's your current favorite?
I don't really like fast food breakfast. Like I go to Dunkin' Donuts because I like the nostalgia factor. mm-hmm. and we're on the West Coast, and mm-hmm. it feels like an East Coast establishment, and
like we walk in like we own the place, right. and order the thing that like no one else knows is on the menu. You're like, oh, you can do that? You can get liquid sugar in your iced coffee so it doesn't just sit as a lump at the bottom? That's crazy.
I mean, and their plain coffee is it's bad. It's really bad. It tastes burnt. It's really bad. So I get like cold brew there, which is whatever. I get that for breakfast the most. Dunkin' Donuts.
Okay. Yeah,
the little tiny wraps.
You know, for breakfast, I have two favorites, and they're different from yours.
Yep.
McDonald's, which is like right across the street from my work, which is dangerous because like any day that you don't wake up in time or like don't want to prepare anything to eat at home, mm-hmm. you've always got the excuse of like McDonald's is actually like a stone's throw from where I work, and it's like it's a problem.
Right.
So the best thing there, I think, is the sausage, egg, and cheese McGriddle.
I've never had this before. I've never had this.
Why not? It is a pancake bun injected with syrup.
Oh.
With a sausage patty, an egg, and cheese.
It just sounds like too much. Too much sweet.
Diabetes.
Too much sweet. Yeah, diabetes. That's what it sounds like to me.
But it's so good. And then you forget always that it comes with a hash brown.
I grew up on the McDonald's hash brown.
By like six of them.
Yeah, they're so fucking tasty. And like, there's just so much salt. It's just like a sodium injection.
It really is. It's like I used to have a guinea pig growing up, and it's like the salt lick.
Okay.
You like give them a salt lick, and they spend all day like just licking the thing compulsively. Mm-hmm. And that's how I kind of feel about the hash browns. Like I could totally eat them all day compulsively because of the quantity of salt in them.
Well, it's like all fast food. You know, like the bliss point concept. Yes. Right? So they utilize this idea of like the combination of like sweet flavors, high sodium, and whatever else to create this thing that's like what you hunger for when you hunger for fast food.
So that's why I'm so addicted to the McGriddle, which has sweet and cheese and fatty ass sausage and a bunch of protein in the egg. It's like every flavor. I think the only thing that might make that a little better is a little bit of hot sauce, and I've never tried that, and want to now.
That wouldn't be too many flavors, because I feel like it's just too much going on. Like I feel like my groggy early morning self palate would be overwhelmed
with hot sauce,
by like sweet, the savory, the cheese, mm-hmm. like everything at once just mm-hmm. feels like it would be like I need like some kind of wrappy type thing, egg and cheese, and anything more makes me overwhelmed.
I need like dense, soak up the yesterday's feelings.
Okay.
Breakfast.
Gotcha. Yeah.
The other one though that I've been, that's now not across from my work.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, now that I'm like therapizing myself and like realizing that like fast food breakfast is like my moment of weakness.
Oh. Okay.
Because I'm like I'm driving by it in the morning and I know I'm gonna be hungry at 10. Like I can't skip breakfast today. I better eat some fast food breakfast because I didn't bring any.
Yeah.
Taco Bell.
Oh, really?
Dude, they've got good breakfast. They've got this thing called the loaded scrambler or like griller or something like that.
Okay.
And it's egg in a wrap with fried potatoes, like Crispy we were talking about last time.
Yeah.
This is where I got the idea, like the fried potatoes in it. A little bit of like pico de gallo in air quotes because Taco Bell doesn't have real pico de gallo. And like a ranch sauce.
Oh.
Like a little bit of ranch sauce. And it's like unbelievable. It's like a ranchy sour cream. It doesn't taste like ranch. It has a little bit of the ranch spices in it.
Weird.
But it's like more of a sour cream than like a buttermilk base.
We have talked about ranch.
Delicious.
On this podcast before. And I'm not a big ranch fan. But if it works, if it's a little thicker, it's a little sour cream-like.
It works. It's not like the first thing I thought of. Like if I had, I've had like five of them before.
Mm-hmm.
The first two times I didn't know what it was.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Like it's like that mystery flavor. You're like, what is that?
Yeah.
And why is it adding this great texture and flavor to my fast food meal?
Nice.
So Taco Bell and McDonald's are my go-tos for breakfast.
I usually, the only times I've really gone to fast food for breakfast are the occasional Dunkin' Donuts. And like drive-through wise, I mean, our Dunkin' Donuts isn't a drive-through, but like I usually don't go to fast food. I did it when we did the road trip from Massachusetts to California, like, every day.
Can you summarize your,
There's no summary for the road trip.
No, your your fast food experience on the road trip.
McDonald's?
Like, only McDonald's?
Yeah. Yeah. Almost entirely McDonald's.
Huh.
And it was, like, for breakfast, it was those disgusting, you get two sausage egg wraps in, like, one of the meals. Like, two tiny, tiny, tiny ones. And that was my breakfast.
Okay.
Yeah.
But, like, that's all there is also, right? It's, like, it's not like you could have gotten to a different fast food place. It's just McDonald's is so ubiquitous when it comes to fast food.
We occasionally went to a Burger King or whatever to mix it up. Or, like, a Jack in the Box. We went to a couple of those.
Tell me your feelings on Jack in the Box. Because you probably had never had it until you moved here.
Yeah, I mean, I had it last time I lived here.
Oh, okay.
It's, like, what is Jack in the Box? Jack in the Box is, like, where fast food ideas go to die. Like, it has so many different kinds. It's like, they have tacos, they have burgers, they have, like, a bunch of different types of fast food cuisines that places usually specialize in.
They have breakfast all day.
Right. Breakfast all day. It's just like, Jack in the Box is the anything goes. To me, in my mind, that's actually the lowest tier of the drive through fast food places. Like, Jack in the Box is the worst.
Yeah, one. They have jalapeno poppers,
yep.
Curly fries,
yep.
Regular fries. These are like, this is their sides menu. Tacos, which I've heard a rumor that aren't even beef.
They're fake beef.
but the one thing that they do really well is their Oreo shake.
I've never.
You can't mess up a shake.
Tried that.
It's so good.
It's like, how do you discover that something like that is good? It's just, you know, you're really...
You just know, order one day, or someone else. Like, I feel like my thing is, like, when you go to the fast food drive-thru, you hope you're not alone.
It's true.
Right?
Like, oh, no.
Because then you get to, like, pick up on other people's orders, and you, like, you'll try them at some point.
Yep. It's true. Because, like, going to the fast food alone is kind of bleak sometimes.
Yeah, and it's become a regular occurrence in my life.
I used to do it all the time.
Well, it's one of those things where, like, grocery shopping,
yeah,
like, if you can get a 20 piece nugget at McDonald's for $5.
Yep.
And, like, try to figure out a meal that I can eat for under $5 that's as satisfying as
totally.
That.
And it makes you feel full. I mean, it's just like, it's so affordable. Like, especially when I was, like, younger and in college or high school or whatever, you know, less income, and I would just go to fast food multiple times a week. Every day, sometimes.
Yeah.
Like, some weeks, I would be there every day.
What is the feeling that you get when you've been to fast food? Like, let's say it's, like, Wednesday.
Yeah.
And at this point, you've gone to fast food Monday and Tuesday, and you're trying to decide what you should do. Like, what's the emotional wrestling that you're doing in that moment? To try to, like, justify or unjustify your choice to keep going.
Well, it's easy to justify because it's so cheap, right? So
right.
It's like $5 and you got a meal, which is crazy. And then I just tried to ignore the health aspect, rationalize it with, like, I exercise, I run, I can do this, I'm young. These kinds of, like, rationalizations. And I would just think about what it feels like emotionally, what it feels like, or what the bliss point does to me when I take a bite of a burger, kind of like also kind of eat some fries and drink a Coke in like under like a 30 second time period when I've eaten and consumed all those things at once and the tastes and are all there. And I just think happy thoughts.
It's fine.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Everything's going to be okay.
Like, on a week like that in the past, I feel like I've had extreme, like, self-loathing when it comes to Wednesday.
Okay.
Where I'm almost like, all right, it looks like it's going to be one of those weeks. And I just, like, kind of resign myself to it. And
yeah.
I dive right in. And sometimes, by Thursday, I'm like, oh, I'm going to treat myself. I'm not going to order off the dollar menu today. I'm going to get the meal deal.
Oh, really? Yeah.
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 What's your favorite chicken nugget dipping sauce from all fast food places?
McDonald's sweet and sour.
That's, oh, wow. Yeah, that's mine too.
I mean, McDonald's chicken nuggets also are the top. McDonald's fries are also the top.
What about the Szechuan sauce?
I've never consumed it. Did you consume it?
I feel like I might have. Like, I have, like, a vague recollection of that promo.
Okay, the Mulan promo.
But it might be because I watched so much Rick and Morty promo footage and, like, then rewatched the commercial. Like, I remember the commercial.
Okay.
After having rewatched the commercial.
Right.
But I don't remember if I had it or not. But I do remember, like, being taken to McDonald's to collect the tiny Beanie Babies that they had. And I feel like that all happened the same time.
I did that, too. Why did I care about that?
I think it, not to throw the generation before us under the bus, a lot of people thought that that was a real good get-rich-quick scheme. God and what damn. Better way to get three tiny Beanie Babies than to take your entire family to McDonald's for tiny Beanie Babies
and get rich quick. Is it just me, or is it like the generation before us and get rich quick schemes go hand in hand?
That plus, I feel like it was their podcasting.
Yeah.
You know, like they didn't have access, unfettered access to the internet. Therefore, like their get rich quick scheme was like read People Magazine.
And like, learn about this like thing that people are trying to do to get money.
But not even like, not to like equivocate podcasting to a get rich quick scheme.
It's
but
certainly
like,
not that.
What I mean... What I mean is like the hobby factor, right?
Yeah.
Like, what do you do in the days? Like, you know, you need something to fill that like mid 20s, early 30s. Like,
I don't have as many friends as I thought I would. That thing we keep saying.
And the generation before us all had children at this age instead of us, like, just not.
God, yeah.
So I think that's why we had the tiny Beanie Babies.
It's also why we went to McDonald's and fast food all the time. Like, I went to fast food all the time. My grandmother brought me to fast food.
Yeah.
My grandfather brought me to
fast
food.
It definitely was not as taboo as it is.
No, and it was standard fare.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, we don't feel like making something. Let's have an adventure and get in the car and go out somewhere.
To the drive
and crawl around in this, like, fucking germ-infested tube. Before and after eating disgusting food.
What percentage of friends' cars that you got into were French fry cars?
What's the... Oh, they
smelled
like French
fries? Where they smelled
like
and had French fries in them.
Very high.
Yeah.
Do you mean during high school?
Like,
or do you mean
no,
like as a kid?
As a kid, like getting
very
in like
high.
Getting in like your mom's friend's cars.
Oh yeah.
And like they're just like they're French fry cars.
70%.
Yeah. They were up there.
Would be my guess. French fry cars. Yeah.
There's a lot of them. And they might not even be that high, but like those are the only cars I remember from being a child. It's like getting into the cars where like, you know the little like track where the seat slides back?
Yep.
Like
French fries.
I just
there.
Like I have whenever I see those, I'm like, there should be a French fry. It's like French fry home.
This rack is this like little track is lonely without its
without
French fry.
Without a French fry. I know you all know what I'm talking about out there, deskers.
I know that feeling. I know that feeling.
So we got a little bit off track. We were talking about like what is and is not.
Yeah,
fast
what counts
food.
As fast food.
Mm-hmm.
So does like. If walk-in, okay, so it's we decided that it was, like, taste and cost. So mm-hmm. The taste can't be too good, basically, and the cost can't be too high.
Right. So it's, like, the perfect marriage of, like sevens.
Yeah.
Right? Like, you need, like, a 7 on the taste factor and a 7 on the cost factor. Are you going to go lower on numbers there?
I'm going to go lower. I mean, it needs to be, like, a 3 or 4 on the cost factor or lower. Like, it's a max.
Oh, if we're doing, like, a global cost factor
yeah,
where
yeah.
10 is, like, Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. And
right. So I guess then it's more like
a 1.
A 1
is rice and beans.
Or 2. Yeah. So it needs to be, like, around 2.
Yeah.
Like, and then
I would
the
say
taste.
3 sounds good, yeah.
Taste factor, I mean, like, we could argue about this, but I'm totally split on it. Like, sometimes I think of fast food as, like, the ideal taste.
Mm.
And sometimes I think of it as, like, bullshit.
Right.
But it's a bullshit ideal, which makes it a 4.
Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, because I could, I mean, there's days where like, chicken nuggets are a 10 for me.
I think about fast food and, like, put it off. And when I do get it, like, now it's, like, once a month or once every couple months or whatever.
Yeah.
When I, like, intentionally put it off, I sit down and I enjoy the fuck out
mm-hmm.
of that Big Mac.
I'm so glad right now where I'm at in my personal adventure with fast food. Because I'm over the drive-through fast food.
Okay.
And I'm almost to the point where it's, like, not fast food anymore. It's just a shitty restaurant.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, where it's, like, the
like a
cost. Well, the cost factor is not a 3. Like, right. It's like a 7. Like, I'm paying too much for junk food, for shit food.
Oh, and we got your neighbor.
My neighbor is awesome, everybody. If fantastic you can hear neighbor. It right now, he has three broken vehicles. He has a motorcycle, a shitty car, and a shitty pickup truck. And, you know, once an hour or so, just so they don't die, he likes to go out to the parking lot and just start them up. Just fire them up.
I've been here for, what, an hour and a half in Will's apartment, and this is the second time during this hour and a half that he's going and failing at starting his cars and then eventually starting his cars.
Yeah. So shout out to you.
So apologies for the background noise, but we're not cutting it.
No.
So fast food, like, leads me to the question, is, like, a Chili's fast food? Is that what you're talking about? Like, you go in and buy shitty food?
So my new addiction is, like, cheesesteak.
I do love cheesesteaks.
So I go to the cheesesteak shop.
Yep.
And it costs me about $12 to get a cheesesteak and a drink.
Yep.
And I wait for about 5 to 6 minutes for them to make it for me.
Yep.
Like, it feels like just like a regular old house of pizza, except upcharged. Like, it doesn't feel like fast food because it doesn't fit the equation, but
it
feels like junk food, which I think I lump into the fast food category.
Right. It's not, fast food and junk food are not exactly the same. Yeah, that's definitely true.
Yeah, because you can get a salad at McDonald's.
Right. And you can get cheesesteak.
Can you get cheesesteak at the
shop?
I was going to say, if you could get cheesesteak at McDonald's, I feel like I would go.
But are these chains fast food? Like TGI Fridays? They're terrible food.
I think they might just be bad.
I would actually just prefer I would prefer McDonald's to TGI Fridays. I would prefer McDonald's to fucking Cheesecake Factory. Can we talk about that restaurant for a second?
I am not familiar. I've only been 2 times, I think. Tell me about it.
They bill themselves as like a nice restaurant to go to.
Really?
Like, there's one in Walnut Creek downtown where the mall is. Yeah. And it looks fancy, but you go in and it's like disgusting, like over-caloried food for what it is.
All I can think of is like, I feel like they just serve Alfredo dishes.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yeah. And even if you get a steak, then there's like Alfredo injected into it.
But they
it's disgusting.
But they probably have like 2 options, right? They have like Alfredo.
Uh-huh.
And then like Lobster Alfredo, which comes from a can.
Or their fried mac and cheese balls, like, that sit in a sauce or something.
Listeners, I wish you could see physical reactions to statements, because I just, like, my shoulders just collapsed when Ryan said fried mac and cheese balls. I'm just like, who's the guy or girl in charge?
But then people line up outside of this place, like, all the time, and people think of it as good, but it's like, I went and looked it up, and it's like, at least a couple years ago when I did it, Cheesecake Factory has like the worst food for you that you can get. Calorie to positive thing about the food wise.
To price.
Like,
which
price
is expensive.
Probably. It's expensive.
I got a story about Cheesecake Factory, though. It's not my story. I wasn't there.
Someone else's story.
It's someone else's story about Cheesecake. Well, it's my story about someone else's Cheesecake Factory.
All right. Let's hear it.
One of my old roommates had, like, gone on, like, a second date to Cheesecake Factory and, I guess, was really possessive over his leftovers because of emotional reason. I don't know.
What? Okay.
But, really drunkenly, a friend of mine who was staying over went into the fridge on New Year's Eve. Like, let's, like, be real here. On New Year's Eve, you're gonna get drunk and you're gonna have friends over and your friends are gonna do things that you may not approve of or know that are happening. So my buddy goes into the fridge and takes my roommate's leftover Cheesecake Factory and puts it onto 5 plates and reheats it for the people who are hanging out in my room.
Which seems honestly okay to me.
Right. So we all consumed this mystery food, which, like, we were too drunk to question. And that caused a rift. For, like, you know, in college, you live with someone from, like, September to May, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So in January, caused a 4-month rift between me and this guy. Because he was so possessive of his Cheesecake Factory leftovers. Like, he didn't like me anymore. Because my friend ate his food. And he's like, good people don't have shitty friends like that. And that's what he said to one of the other roommates about why he was like,
something's wrong,
mad at me.
There's something going on in that person's life.
We all know. I'm not going to link his Twitter or anything. But if you see a Twitter handle in the description, that's whose it is.
Sounds like maybe he's, I don't know. He seems inherently evil to me.
It's sad because he's a doctor now.
Oh, God. All right. Watch out for your doctors, everyone. Don't take their fucking leftovers.
Especially anyway. Cheesecake.
So the Cheesecake Factory, I guess we got off, but like some place like a TGI Fridays could be, I could hear our listeners out in the ether potentially arguing.
But that's fast food, Ryan.
Right.
I mean, I just think it's bad food.
It's just bad food. So fast food is neither, it doesn't have to be bad food, and it doesn't have to be, not all bad food is fast food, not all junk food is fast
food. And no Alfredo is fast food.
No Alfredo is fast food.
I can't think of a fast food Alfredo.
That's gross. I mean, there's a really good reason that I have never been to or really heard of a strictly, like, pasta-oriented or Italian cuisine-oriented fast food restaurant, right?
Maybe there's an opportunity there.
Maybe.
That we're missing.
Maybe.
We could call it pasta your prime, and
pasta lasagna. Don't get any on ya. That's the thing. That's the tagline.
If any of you out there are like venture capitalists and want to fund any of our harebrained ideas, like, we're willing to work hard for these things.
That's true. We want money. we're trying to figure out, because really we're trying to get to the core of here is what is not fast food. So TGI Fridays is not fast food.
What about? I don't think so. Do you think so?
No, I don't think so either. But we had to figure it out.
But now they've got the curbside to go stuff at those places. Yeah. So you're really just paying the restaurant upcharge to not eat there.
I wonder, is it more expensive or less expensive?
I doubt they change the prices. Otherwise,
you don't have to tip.
Otherwise no one would dine in. It's right, true. If they lowered the prices on the takeout.
It's true. But, like, what about a diner?
Oh, like Mel's?
Like a 24-hour diner.
Or, like, Harry's?
Yeah, Harry's in Northborough, Massachusetts. Shout out.
Yeah,
go there.
Awesome.
Love that
place. They're, like, whole fried clams.
It's
really
weirdly
good
if you want, like, bad.
The raspberry lime Ricky.
Ah.
What's a Ricky?
I don't know.
I mean, I know it's raspberry and lime, and it's delicious, but, like...
Someone's uncle?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, it was like Ricky's. It was old Ricky.
I feel like Ricky is.
He really loved his raspberries and limes. Yeah. Add his name to the end of the drink. Yeah, diners. I think diners. It's like a short order chef. I mean, you spent a long time working at a diner. I spent a short time working at a diner before I was fired.
I did it for 5 years or so. Maybe a little more.
You lasted 5 years. I lasted like 5 weeks at the same establishment.
Yeah, well, that's a shitty place to work. Shout out to Dave.
Hi, Dave.
He
might like this. Really, he actually really actually would really like this like podcast. Dave. Yeah, I do too.
Yeah.
I don't even dislike him for having fired me.
No, like, no. He fired me many times.
He fired me because he was going through shit, not because I was a bad worker.
Mm-hmm. That's what it always was, and if you had just showed up the next day, he would have been like,
here's your money.
Fine. I don't know if it... I'm actually torn on this one. I don't know if diners count as fast food, because it is fast, right? It doesn't usually really go out of the price range thing, but that might be what disqualifies it.
Mm-hmm.
And it certainly isn't so good that it leaves the fast food... Like, it doesn't taste so good that it leaves the fast food zone.
No.
It's almost in there.
It's almost in there.
But you have to eat it there.
Right.
And that might be.
And there's, like, a lot of, I feel like you can do, diners are the place where you go to sit for a little longer.
True.
To be able to customize what you would get at a drive-thru. Like, let's say you want to, like, really dig into, like, I want a medium rare burger. Like, you're never going to get a medium rare burger at McDonald's. Like, it's, right. like, a little bit better, a little bit more expensive.
Yep.
But you get to pick what you want, you know, like you might be able to get some toppings that you wouldn't consider.
And you also sit there for a long time. You like drink the coffee refills. They're usually bottomless coffees, right? So you drink like 7 or 8.
And it
probably.
Seems like a good place to go, like, locally.
Yep.
That's not a place where, like, there's a ton of drunk people. Like, true. It's a cool place to be a regular.
Especially late night. Yeah. All right. Late night diner. I think we should go to one.
Yeah.
Just to hang out.
Well, so we've already decided today during this podcast that we're going to go to Sonic. And we're going to go to a diner just to hang out.
Yep. In the near future. We'll do a podcast from a diner. In the near future.
Look out in your feeds for the episode titled From a Diner.
So I think I think
diner.
We should. I think we should figure out what our favorite. Let's rank them.
Okay.
The drive-thrus.
Okay.
Cause
so it needs to have a. Does there need to be like one that has a drive-thru, or do like most of them need to be drive-thru places?
Should we rank them, or should we name our top? We could name our top drive-thru, our top walk-in, and our top delivery.
Okay. Yeah, I can do that.
Let's do that.
Go for it.
All right, so walk-in. And I actually want to take a moment here because I want to talk about Chipotle again.
Go.
We talked about Chipotle previously.
I'm
going to
like
podcast.
Wind you up and let you go because I feel like I agree with you on that.
I'm stretching. Chipotle is like one of the most bullshit places to get food in the United States because they always set up shop right near some fucking taqueria and put them out of business. A. Mm-hmm. B. You go in there, everything tastes the same. You can order a burrito bowl,
cilantro.
Tacos.
Cilantro.
You could order a burrito with
cilantro.
Veggies?
Cilantro.
You could order a
it
burrito
tastes like
with
cilantro.
Pork. You could order a burrito with chicken.
Cilantro.
all of this shit tastes exactly the same, and it's, you're right, it's cilantro, and it's also, I believe that all of their, both of their rices, and their taco, soft taco shells, and their burrito tortillas are all made out of the exact same bland-ass shit. Like, it's the same fucking taste, and nothing they put in it makes that taste any better or worse. It's a little mm-hmm. spicier or a little less spicy.
Like they
it's
have
like
the,
eating fucking cardboard.
They have the high ground on like fresh ingredients.
But they give everyone salmonella every year. It's like every fall, there's a major salmonella outbreak.
And it's so funny because like the reason that they're getting salmonella is because they're buying local fresh produce.
It's possible.
And it's like interesting.
They can
no, no,
buy
it's
better.
Like it is. Like it was yeah. traced, like the whole outbreak.
Uh-huh.
It was all traced back to like specific farms at specific times that had contaminated produce. And because it's all, you know, like it's all been like they buy from thousands of vendors instead of
right.
buying from one.
Right. So they
and
have less
your
control.
Your risk. Well, right. Your risk vulnerability is much larger when you're buying from all these different vendors,
mm-hmm.
which is why those outbreaks for Chipotle were regional.
Yep.
Like they were like Northern California and New England. And that's
yep.
it.
Yep.
And like there were some in central, but like there were three different viruses and it was like,
mm-hmm.
it's crazy. There's a video on YouTube. Check it out. Like the like science behind the outbreak. Of
oh,
Chipotle.
Cool.
But it also like just isn't that good. Like, first of all, I don't like rice in my burritos. You all know that. And second of all, Chipotle puts way too much rice in their burritos.
Way too much.
And the line's too long. And the burrito is almost too big where it falls apart when you're eating it.
Yep.
And guacamole is like $2.50.
That's
$2.50.
That is crazy.
Yeah. Fuck Chipotle. Fuck you, Chipotle. We don't
fuck
like
you.
Fuck
you, Chipotle. So my least favorite fast food place is Chipotle.
Yeah.
But my number one drive-thru, I'm going to say, is McDonald's. Just because they got the fries down, they got the chicken nuggets down, and I go way back with McDonald's.
Mm-hmm.
As a kid, I ate the chicken nuggets. As a teenager, I got the 20. Now
mm-hmm.
you have to order two 10s, but they used to have a single box that has 20
oh.
in it.
Did you know that the 10 piece, I've already told, I think
yeah,
I've already given
already,
the podcast
yeah, yeah.
people the tip.
But go over it again.
The
yeah.
10 piece is like $4.79 and the 20 piece is like $5. It's,
yep.
it's ridiculous.
Get the fucking 20 piece.
Even
share
if
it with your
like,
friends.
Yeah, or give it to a homeless person.
Yeah, do something. So McDonald's for sure. I'm trying to think about my favorite walk-in. I worked at a Subway, so it's definitely not my favorite. What other walk-in places exist? Do all sandwich shops count as walk-in, or does it get too expensive? Like, Ike's is too expensive.
Yeah, that's not fast. I mean, it's not even fast.
It's not even fast.
It's definitely food, though, and it's good food.
It's so, so good.
Walk-in places, fast food walk-in places. Like, I feel like Panda Express, right, where it's all made
right,
and they scoop
right.
it for you.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I might not like any of them. I think if I want fast food, I want to go through the drive-thru. I might just say no to walk-in fast food.
Because if you're going to walk in there, you may as well step your game up and go either to a better restaurant or go buy some groceries. Because you're like already out and about. Like, it becomes laziness at that point where you're like going walking into Panda Express and having them scoop things into a bowl for you.
And it's disgusting. I'd rather get my disgusting thing handed to me anonymously without eye contact.
I like that. So my like, I'm hard-pressed to figure out my favorite drive-thru.
Okay.
I'm going to go through and name reasons why I may choose this one, and then I think I'm going to choose something else.
Okay, okay.
I really love the way that In-N-Out handles their drive-thru.
Me too.
Where they, like, walk up to you before you get to the speaker, and they, like, put your order in on an iPad.
Yeah.
And I think that's awesome. And they're, like, super friendly. Like, they're, like, all... It's, like, a Christian restaurant. Like, them and Chick-fil-A are, like, very...
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it actually Christian-owned or something?
They have, like, if you look on the bottom of the drinks and, like, on the bottom of the, like, trays of food, they have, like, Bible verses. Like, not, like, the full verse, but, like, it'll be, like, Ezekiel 15:12 or whatever. And, like, terrifying. They, like, just say that.
Is that that In-N-Out or Chick-fil-A? Oh,
yeah. God. Well, Chick-fil-A is definitely religious.
Well, that's, like, shitty religious.
Shitty religious, yeah. I've only been there one time. Just to, like,
I've never been.
Say I've been.
Yeah.
But I haven't gone back, because I don't really agree with their agenda. But goddamn if their chicken isn't fantastic.
I've never been.
So I want to say In-N-Out for their customer service mixed with their burgers, but I'm going to throw something controversial out there and say they're a little overhyped.
I think they are a little overhyped.
It's good, and it's consistent, but it's borderline not fast food. The lines are so long, and it's not because the food doesn't come out fast, it's because there's so many people who want it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, like, overhyped. So I think In-N-Out, like, is going to be lower on my list. But, like, I want it to be my favorite, but I just can't get over that. And I can't get over the nostalgia pump of McDonald's.
You're going to McDonald's, too?
I think so, too, yeah.
Nice.
McDonald's is one of those places where you don't run out of things to be like, oh, that's good.
Right.
Like, if I don't want... My typical orders are the quarter pounder, but you add Big Mac sauce.
You can do that? I've mm-hmm. never tried that.
It's amazing.
Nice.
Because you don't have to deal with this shitty second bun.
Yeah.
And you get one patty instead of two.
Yeah.
So, like, it's better. And the quarter pounder also doesn't have lettuce on it, which I think is a bullshit filler hamburger topping.
I like the lettuce.
I don't like lettuce.
I want the crunch.
So I do, I want, like, you get the crunch from the onions and the pickles.
Mm.
The quarter pounder with Big Mac sauce or the 20-piece nuggets, no fries, and a drink.
Yeah, that's great. I also occasionally go for their like fried chicken sandwich is pretty damn good.
That's what I was going to say.
It's like a giant chicken nugget.
Yeah, I can't get to the point where I will order chicken pretty much anywhere unless it's McDonald's chicken nuggets. This is something I'm realizing like as I'm saying it out loud.
Yeah.
I like have this thing against not ordering like chicken at restaurants. I think it's a waste. I think chicken's cheap and it's easy to make. And unless you're getting wings or nuggets, you get dry, shitty chicken at restaurants.
Yeah, wings I always do.
Mm-hmm.
I very rarely order, like, restaurant chicken, that's for sure.
Are there any good fast food wings?
Not that I know of.
Like, Buffalo Wild Wings isn't fast food.
No.
That's slow.
That's slow, shitty food.
Their wings are really good, though.
They are good. I do like the bone-in wings there.
I tried their scorpion chili sauce last time I went there.
Was it hot?
It was really hot.
Hmm. Like in a good way?
The order had like 6 wings. And I split them with a friend, with Jeff.
Conspiracy Jeff.
And I'm glad that I didn't have to eat all 6. I'll say that.
Okay.
Like if I wasn't splitting them, I wouldn't have finished them.
Huh.
And they're served with vanilla ice cream.
Blech. Just to take it off. Like,
yeah, because it's too hot. But it's pretty tasty. But yeah, McDonald's, I think, would be my pick. Because you can go chicken nuggets, you can go burger.
Yep.
Their salads are really good,
too. I've never tried
their
salads.
You can sub fries for salads now.
Okay.
This is like, you can tell.
Oh, that's the move to make.
You can tell what I'm obviously grappling with in my head. Like, where I'm like, oh, well, let me get the 20 nuggets and a salad and a Diet Coke. Like, fuck off.
20 nuggets and the salad. Big Mac and the Diet Coke, please. Dear God.
And then you get yourself in this situation where the salads are so good that you order the 20 nuggets and 2 salads and you save one for later.
I want to go back to
Ladies, I'm available.
You still got the eye thing going on. I
got the eye thing and multiple salads.
Yeah, got an extra salad. I wanna circle back though, because you talking about In-N-Out made me decide what my favorite walk-in place is.
Is it In-N-Out?
It's Five Guys.
Oh,
I love
Five Guys.
Five Guys. It's gross. It's fast food. It's greasy. two patties are standard.
That's so weird.
It's so weird, but they're so good. It's like the best hangover food I've ever had, without question.
Have you ever had one of those smashed burgers?
What is that?
That are like really thin, and they put like two patties on a bun. Like the double is standard, is what reminded me of it. I've never had it, but I've seen like copious. So like basically you like make a really thin burger patty.
Yeah.
And then you take like a trowel and you like.
You squish
you
it?
You smash it.
Okay.
And like it's kind of like burnt really thin, like a minute on each side, thin burger.
It's like a well done
egg. But
they
cover in cheese. Yeah, it's like an egg.
Okay.
But it's a burger.
I would try that. I would try anything.
It sounds good. I think there's a place called Smash Burger. And I think that's where they make it.
Nice.
What's my favorite walk-in place? I think cheesesteak is good, but it's not fast food, I think I determined.
Well, in some cases, it's just too expensive.
It's too expensive, but Five Guys is too expensive, too. You can't leave there for under $15.
But the place that is called cheesesteak
shop,
that might be fast food. The food quality might be low enough to counteract the fact that you're paying $9 for the thing.
Is it that low?
It might be. I mean, I love it.
I feel like I'm in a bubble of love.
Yeah, and then delivery? I don't really think that there is a delivery that I truly like. Delivery pizza is something I do.
I like only get delivery pizza.
Yeah, I do it when I need it.
And it's like pizza and wings.
I'm being lazy.
Always together.
Uh-huh.
And the pizza... What's your... I feel like we always get a specific pizza when we order pizza together. But what's your, like, favorite pizza? Like, I feel like that's I feel like the pizza that we order as a team...
Right.
...is a compromise. What's your favorite pizza?
My number one favorite pizza would be either a buffalo chicken, but done in the way that's, like, that the buffalo sauce is not replacing the tomato sauce, right?
I...
Because that's bullshit.
Yes.
And then there's also, in addition to the thing that people fuck up with buffalo stuff a lot is they go either like the creamy buffalo dressing or just buffalo crumble, and there needs to be buffalo cheese crumble and the creamy dressing stuff.
Okay.
And
like
if it's
on
one
top,
or the other,
like drizzled?
Just like somewhere, yeah, drizzled on top, back and forth, or just kind of like yeah. In there. In
what
the
if
mix.
They made like.
Or on the side
what
even.
What if they made a mix of like buffalo blue cheese? Is that fun?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So that's your favorite.
That's my favorite.
I do love buffalo chicken pizza as well.
I also
well.
Really go for anything with pineapple on it, pizza wise.
Me, you, and Matt used to get the chicken and pineapple.
That's a really good.
Which is good.
Because the ham. On the Hawaiian is too fucking salty.
Salty,
most of the
time. Right. So that was I feel like there was like a conversation where we were like. Okay, well, we want a Hawaiian pizza, but it's too salty. How about chicken? Because it's not. And it worked, and that was the chicken
pineapple.
That was
the standard, yeah.
That was a
good
order.
For, like, many years.
I haven't had that in a long time, because now I go for pepperoni, which I never used to go for as
That's what we do, usually.
I always used to do cheese, and then, like, somewhere along the line, I started liking pepperoni pizza.
Yeah.
I don't know
it's
where
good.
It came from, pepperoni, and then, so the new thing. This
Your
is
new
what
thing?
I realized.
Yeah.
It's the best. So you get a pepperoni pizza with onions and garlic.
Oh, that does sound pretty good.
They'll put garlic on the pizza for you, and the whole thing tastes like garlic bread as well as pizza. And it's like a trick where you don't have to order the breadsticks anymore.
That sounds like it's leaning into the bliss point a little bit. Because you got your cheese, you got your savory,
yeah.
And the garlic seems like maybe they put some garlic salt on there, so there's your sodium.
Oh, no, it's fresh garlic.
Oh, it's fresh garlic?
Yeah,
oh, okay.
And it's like you can see it, and it's like good and
That's tasty.
Thick and like, oh, like 10 cloves of garlic at least on your pizza.
Yeah.
And you're like, yes.
When we make pizzas at home... I usually put like tons of fucking garlic on it, just like in with the sauce before the cheese.
Yeah, it's so good,
super good. Well, so
on
we
that
need,
note, we're hungry.
We need to say we need to say yes or no to fast food.
Yes, and I'm gonna make a case for it as I say yes. I legit can eat healthy at a lot of fast food places for less than it costs me to eat healthy at home. Because I'm only shopping for myself. And it's, I think it saves me on regular occasions. Like that thing about the McDonald's salad, like that wasn't, I mean, they're like $1.50.
Yeah.
And they're
that's
like,
real.
They're like pretty good. And if you don't use their dressing, they're like very low carb.
Mm-hmm.
And like, it's just, you know, if you're dying and you don't want to eat shit food, like, there's some places you can go and get some healthy shit for pretty cheap. So that's, like, why I'm leaning towards it. But then there's also places you can go and really fuck your system up.
Yep.
And that's the way I prefer to do those types of places. So yes to fast food for me.
Same. I mean, okay, so I feel like I'm in the situation with the yes or no where it's like, I want to say no, but I have to say yes. Because I'll be misrepresenting myself.
Yeah, it's like dishonest to say no.
Like, I wish I could say no, but the whatever, the necessity of it, and maybe also like my long-term, what I would definitely call an addiction to it. Because when I think about it, I feel like endorphin release. I feel pleasure.
Compulsion to get in the car and drive there.
And when I get it, I feel pleasure. And then when I'm done with it, I feel a little guilty and a little shitty. And then I just want to do it again the next day. So, or the next hour. So
it is easy to get on that track.
So I have to say yes.
Okay.
All right.
So listeners, thanks for tuning in. Are you a fast fooder? Do you avoid it like the plague? Chime in the YouTube comments. Leave us a review and a 5-star on our iTunes. And check out our Twitter, because we're going to be posting all kinds of good information about our podcast tour. Beginning the same day that you'll hear this podcast, we're also available on the Desert Island Discourse podcast. Our friends Max and Andrew are releasing our discussion about the King of Limbs that we had last week.
Yep. So, it's going to be good. Listen to it.
First stop on the tour. Check out the Twitter for updates. Thanks for listening. I'm Will.
I'm Ryan.
This is the Walnut Desk Podcast.